I thought I'd figured it out at 30, okay? I had bought my own home and things were going great until my girlfriends called an intervention, which started with these very words. You know, Tess, if you were a guy, we would all stand in line to date you. What's wrong with you? Why aren't you, like, dating someone? You've been single for so long. There's something wrong and we have a solution. The internet. And I laughed because I thought it was funny, but they were really serious. And they said, give us a year of your life and trust me, we'll do it right. And so it all began. A week later, I got a giggling, squealy call saying 300. So I said, what, the movie? And they said, no, we've got 300 emails and interests from guys across India and the world. So now I was supposed to sieve through these and like applications, kind of eliminate the crazies, the ones which had portfolios which looked like they were actors, and third, the mama's boys, whose profiles always read, my son is so amazing. I just want him to be happy. If only you could find me one fair Brahmin, baby producing, good cook girl. My first date was with this ice cream maker entrepreneur. Okay, so I called my mom before and she said, hi, Baba loves ice cream, imagine. One whole lifetime of free ice cream. I was early and 5 minutes before he walked in, my mother's SMS came saying, enjoy the ice cream. He was great. He was lovely. We talked and we laughed and then we realized we awkwardly had a lot of friends in common. And then when we slipped into discussions about our exes, it was too familiar. So we decided that the only way we would see each other again is one of those mutual parties which we had been invited to. The next was this Mallu, Malayali, architect artist, who just before he was supposed to turn up, sent me an SMS saying, baby, I hope you're wearing heels because I like my women tall. 45 minutes later, a 5'1" man walked in, leaned on my table and said, have you been waiting long? He showed me his artwork, and I want you to imagine this with me because I can swear to God it was made on Microsoft Paint, okay? So think blue, think brown, think green. And with Arial font, think of the words sky, cloud, cloud, mountain, sheep, sheep, grass. When I asked him, what is this? He said, I need the audience to imagine the art for me. At the end of the day, I sent him a black and white SMS saying, sorry, but never again. He wrote back to me saying, you know, baby, we could have been art together. Now, some were all not that bad. There was the biker boy with his wild hair and his kind face who on a rainy day walked me up to my doorstep and leaned forward and said, say goodbye to me properly. I being, I think, a combination of her and the wine, thought the way to say goodbye properly to a biker guy going on a road trip in the monsoon was to pat him on his back and say, drive safely. There was a 6'2" Canadian Indian writer, wrestling enthusiast. He had boyish charm, but he kept writing about wanting to lift me up and swing me around. And I kind of wrote him what I call the funny goodbye. I said, I'm not a dumbbell. And he wrote back to me and we decided that if we ever met again, we would definitely say hello, whichever continent we were in. There was the Rajput who gave me a sword. And there was the persistent orthopedic surgeon who offered me free surgery for my torn ligament before we got married. No bones were broken in that relationship, but some hearts. Definitely not mine. In June, I got the most beautiful email from this guy called Praveen Nair in Bangalore. He was the head of some fancy MNC. And I remember three of us girls sitting on the couch reading the email, and we had one rule. No profile picture, no go. He didn't have one. But after reading that email, even Arpita, one of my oldest and dearest friends, said, hi, I wish I was single. So I wrote back an even better reply, and then it began this email back and forth for 1 month, which seemed almost romantically old school. And I asked him one day, you know, we were Googling about him and we couldn't find anything, like the name and the company, no Facebook, no social media, nothing. So I asked him, I said, what is this? And he said, listen, in the position I am, it's really hard to put my picture out there. And I said, fair enough, that's good. A month later, he called me. And the first call ended with him asking me, are you sentimental about your birthday? And I said, no. He said, fine, I'm booking a ticket and I'm flying down. I, being the brat I am, said, it's July, will we last till November? And he said, we will. He was amazing. He was well-read and intelligent, a voracious reader, an amateur chef, and he loved movie soundtracks as much as I did. We breezed through till November, and often he would ask me for a picture of myself, and I never thought twice about sending it. And the only picture I had of him was like some group photo of his company meet. I went to the airport with a hand-painted sign of his name, and I had a moment where I said, shit, I don't know what he looks like. So I went back to my WhatsApp and I tried to find that picture, and when I looked up, he was standing right in front of me. What followed over my birthday weekend was the stuff movies were made of. MasterChef breakfast, walks in the sunset, a restaurant chase where he had got different places to make my favorite dishes and we were chasing it all night. On the evening of my birthday, he said, hey, can I cook you a meal? And I said, sure. And he said, but I need a kitchen. So I said, use mine. I mean, there was nothing to it. I walked into candlelight, flowers, and the most perfect meal. It was magic. But after dinner, I could sense he wanted something more, but I wasn't really ready. So I thought I should say it out loud because I didn't want him to misunderstand. I took his hands and I held it to my heart. And I said, you know, I really want to do this, but not tonight. I need a little more time. I'll tell you when I'm ready. Why don't we plan a weekend, just us, before the year's over? He kissed me gently and he took out his computer and we planned this one-week getaway. Just us, nobody else, far away from everything. The next morning, I took him to the airport and the only thing we said to each other was, soon. In the evening, I sent him a WhatsApp. But I didn't get a reply. In the morning, I tried to call him. Nothing. A few days later, I sent him an email. Nothing. I figured he had to be injured or dead. That's the only reason he's not replying to me. So I got a friend of mine to call him. And of course, he picked up. He was very much alive and kicking. I was trying to figure what was the red flag that I missed. Was it something I did? So I went through every single WhatsApp message and the emails we had sent each other for months, scrutinizing every single detail. It's only when you take a step back that you see things clearly. He had never really told me much about his family. And I remembered a random conversation where I was like sopping over this one letter that someone sent me because he was this person working with dogs rescue and I just was taken in by it. And he said, you know, you shouldn't believe all these emails you get online. Most of the time it's just cut, paste and send. So we tried something. We made a parallel profile and we put it out there, kind of similar to mine. And we waited. And voila, surely enough, the email that had stolen my heart came back. We hadn't chosen each other. He had chosen me. He had laid a trap and I had walked straight into it. You know, the odds were always in his favor, but I think fate was on my side because I got to say no that night to a man I had invited to my home. That evening, I sat with my girlfriends on and over sangria and way too much sugar. We said goodbye to the gentlemen that were, the ones who could have been, and the ones who never will be. We deleted photos, shut accounts, and called it a day. Actually, we called it a year. Thank you.
I always think that if you had to do like, subscribe like Thakur in Shole, how would he do it?
He had no hands, he couldn't point. How would you find your way? This is what he'd do. To like, to subscribe, and to follow us.